How are you? If you're new, hi, welcome. My name is Michelle and this is your weekly reading. Before I start, I want to remind you guys that my readings have no date. They are divinely guided. Everything has free will, not everything is going to resonate with everybody. And please keep in mind that roles could be reversed between you and that person. And with that said, as I always say, I do not run a daycare. This is general, so take or leave whatever you want. With that said, let's see what my goddess and the universe has for you, Aries. So we have here the Seven of Cups, the Nine of Cups in reverse, both of them, the Empress. We got here the Strength card in reverse, the Three of Pentacles in reverse, and please overall energy, please. We have right here, we got the Seven of Pentacles in reverse and the Five of Pentacles at the bottom. We got here Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, Libra, Taurus energy, Leo energy, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. So what do we have here? So I do feel here that this seems to be a break on your romantic sense. I feel like you haven't dated in a minute. You haven't found, or it's because you don't want to date in, or because you haven't found somebody. But I feel like some of you have been single for a minute here. Some of you don't even believe that could change, or you don't believe that you can find somebody because, again, every time you try something bad happens or some disappointment happens and you're like, you know what, F that, I'm going to stay single, I'm going to live life. I do feel right here that you are in this Empress energy, like you are in the feminine energy. You don't chase, you attract. You're not closing the door to possibilities, but you're not really looking for anything just now. I feel like you're just living life, surviving, like all of us, working, doing your thing, you know. I do feel like some of you had a haircut or dye your hair or something. I do feel like a change in your energies here. You're looking good. Now, I do feel right here that you're not very optimistic over finding a lover that you can actually have a meaningful relationship, because you feel like nowadays people just want to hook up and that there's not really a interest in more than just one night stand on people. And it's like you consider that it's become very hard to date or to even trying to date because people just don't want what you want, or it's hard to find people with the same interest, you know. I do feel like you have actually lowered your expectations into dating, into like, oh, am I gonna get somebody that likes me or somebody that I can love? And I feel like you have tried, but you know, you have the Queen of Pentacles energies, and what you get is the Five of Pentacles, somebody who don't even care to get to know you. So I do feel like in the love sense, I don't know, I don't see a lot of activity. Let's see. What can you tell me for Aries in the love sense? What's going to happen now? Any changes? What can they expect? So I do see another Aries walking into your life, or this could also be a water sign such as Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpio. Again, with the Tower in reverse, it's confirming to be a Scorpio. This could be another Aries or a Scorpio energy here walking into your life. I also see a Libra, Gemini, and Pisces with the Moon in reverse. So those are the possible initials. I'm sorry, the possible zodiac signs that I see. Of course, you know best when it happens, if it hasn't happened. So I do see here this person can actually, you can meet this person at work, or again, they could visit your work as a customer, and that's when you're gonna meet them. This could be the other way around as well, like you visiting their workplace. I do feel like they could be a little bit older than you. I see possible two possibilities. Older than you or younger than you. It's a small age gap here. Not a big of a deal. I don't think it's a big of a deal for you. I do feel like this person's going to approach you and you're going to be mesmerized. If it's a male, I do see a male with longish hair and a long beard. If it's a female, I do see a female with longer hair. I do see somebody who has brownish. But hold on, guys. Sorry, mom duties. But either way, as I said, this could be the other way around. Age gap, da 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 da. I do feel like they're going to ask you on a date. They're going to ask you if you're working. They're going to be, what time do you get off? And I feel like some of you might be working the night shift or the second shift or something. And after work, because I feel like some of you don't have kids. And if you do have kids, your kids are with your baby daddy or baby mama. But at the end of the day, you're free that night. And you guys are going to go out on a date and, you know, see what things goes. I do feel like you're not having a lot of expectations. You're like, you know what, let's see if this dude or this female disappoints me again or disappoints me at all. Let's see if they can actually, if they are exactly what I look for or not. But I do feel like you're trying to keep it on the low, not putting a lot of expectations because you don't want to be disappointed at all. I do feel like it's gonna be surprising here, because this person seems to be very gracious, very attractive, exactly what you want, exactly what to say. There's not a lot of red flags. I do feel like you're gonna be very comfortable with them. You're gonna be like, oh, okay, so this is worth investing. Like, you are going to be liking this person and maybe considering, like, maybe I want to take it far with this person. So I feel like the idea of staying single or not wanting to date, it's going to change. This person is not a liar. Moon in reverse, Pisces energy. I feel like they're very open about who they are, what they want. They're going to ask you really quick if you have social medias, and you guys are going to follow each other in social medias. Of course, it's not for all of you, because if you don't have social medias, you won't follow anybody. But if you do have social media, and it's for those who know, who have social media, if the shoe don't fit, don't force it, boo boo gaga. But if you know you have social media and that you would share that immediately, some of you, it seems to be that you guys are going to be happy to, you know, exchange not only phone numbers but also social medias as well. And that's when you're going to get to know a little bit more. You're going to understand that this person has been single for a minute as well, after a long-term relationship, because this person that they were engaged to or be with, they were with, this person decided to, you know, end things with them because they didn't want to settle down the same way the person that you're talking to wanted. So your person is right away somebody who takes things seriously and somebody who dates to marry down the road eventually. Not immediately, because that would be crazy, but once again, yes, it's somebody who dates to marry eventually. And if you're not on board for that, I will highly recommend you to double guess it, because this person is a very caring, loving person, and whenever they give it all, they give it all, you know. So if you don't want anything serious right now, and whenever they show up at your doorsteps, just make sure to make the right call for you and for them. But if you know that's not something that you want, that you want to take things to higher levels of commitments with somebody, and it seems to be that this person is your type, then you met your match. Also, there's a possibility for others of you of a pregnancy with this person, so just be careful, you know what I'm saying. If you don't want kids or so, make sure to do the right thing whenever you get down, do the dirty. If you know that, you know that that pregnancy is not a possibility, then don't worry about this part. What else is coming for Aries? I do feel like people who exes or people who stop talking to you, who were interested in you, as this is something that happens kind of often, they're gonna like reach out to you. I do feel like you're not gonna pay attention to that, obviously, because, you know, exes and all that are gonna try to reach out to you right after they see you being happy and doing good. I do feel that you were also, in a way, and this is not related to love, this is related to, let's say, money or so. I do feel like if you were working, you were cut hours, this of you were no longer happy where you work at, and you have been applying since, I will say even before the end of, like, I feel like you have been applying for jobs since, I will say, October, November, and you haven't either or heard back from the ones you wanted, or they show up at one thing and then they realize, you realize that it's not the job for you. Whatever this is, I feel you haven't been lucky, but I do feel that, I feel like in 5 weeks, most of you is going to receive this in 5 weeks. Others of you is going to receive this in 3 to 5 months. But I do feel most of you, Aries, are going to receive a call back from a job that you really, really wanted. And I do feel that you're going to be working with a work bestie there, or a bestie. Like, you guys are going to be able to work with somebody that you already know, that you consider a work bestie, or that you consider a work bestie, or somebody that you like, not like emotional, not romantically, somebody that you like as a friend, you know. So I do feel like there's also a change, a positive change, when it comes to your job situation. I do feel like you're no longer gonna be in a place that you don't like to be. I feel like you go to work because, of course, we need to pay your bills, but I feel like it's gonna be a job that you wanna like, or at least hate less. That's good for me too, you know. I do feel like the job situation right now, you don't like it, is because of your boss, is because of management, the way things are handled and treated. You don't feel very welcome or comfortable. Of course, this part is not for all of you. Again, I have to be this specific because people don't understand what a collective/general reading is. So again, For those who know, this part may belong to you. Again, this is why you don't like the job. It's not because the job is impossible necessarily. It's because whoever is managing, supervising, whatever, is not the best. You're constantly on anxiety on that job. You have anxiety attacks, paranoia. You feel stressed and unhappy. And even the thought of going back to work makes you feel like nauseous. And just so you know, it's because what you're putting up with, and this is not always, like I said before, work. I feel like workload can be a lot too, but I feel like what you're putting up with this kind of management and this kind of people managing you, it's not worth the pay. And I feel you know this, and everybody will say the same, but I do feel like you have to stay there because, you know, you got bills to pay. But I just, you know, there's going to be a big change coming your way. There's a big, big, big ass change coming your way, not only in the love sense, but also in the work sense, when it's going to be opening multiple doors into multiple possibilities that you want to take. I do feel that you have been manifesting this for a minute. Let me get that card, guys. Hold on. You have been manifesting this for a minute, and now it's coming to reality. Just so you know that you are a master manifester, guys, Aries, and just so you know that you have all the tools, all the knowledge, and all the power to make your dreams a reality, and now you're going to be able to see this. Just make sure to use them correctly and for the right reasons. Now moving forward, just so you know, you're going to be moving on into newer things, and just so you know that bigger and better are coming. And even though that right now it seems to be... What? What's up? Hold on, guys. I do feel like bigger and better. It's coming. It's happening. I know it was a slow progress and a slow process, but I do feel like the time is ripe. The time is right. The time is a now. Even though that you don't see it, it's like, it's hard for me to picture that, Michelle. Don't worry. Let it happen, because it'll happen. It's already written in your book, so... Anything else that Aries needs to know? I do feel others of you, and this is for a specific Aries as well. Some of you, I do see a miscarriage happening, and not that it's going to happen. That already happened in the past. And I do feel that it was hard on you, of course. And if it's not you, this could be somebody near you, a sister or somebody near you. Just so you know, Bubu Gaga, that miracle baby is coming. That miracle baby is coming. And some of you may be either or. I feel like some of you could be 5 weeks to 5 months pregnant and you don't notice. Or this could be somebody, that a sister or so, that's 5 weeks or 5 months pregnant. And this is giving like a miracle baby now. People go like, but 5 months, how do you don't notice? When I was pregnant with my son, I didn't realize I was pregnant until 5 months, when I got super sick and I thought I had the worst flu ever, and it was a baby, and my stomach did not look so big, none of that. After this 5 months, that's when my stomach grew, of course. But don't worry, don't, like, people go like, oh, 5 months, like, it doesn't show up until like 6 months sometimes, and some people don't pop until like 8 months. So everybody's different, but I do feel like some of you will be 5 weeks or 5 months pregnant whenever you find out, and that is a miracle baby. Like I said before, if it's not you, because in any way you perform, you know it's not you, this could be somebody near you, a sister, a coworker that you care for, somebody near you, okay? But there is it showed up in your energies, because this person is, it, I don't know, you care for this person in a way, even if it's a co-worker, bestie, let's say. But either way, yeah, it's gonna be a surprise. This is divinely guided. Don't worry about it. Everything's happening the way it should be happening. It's not the end of the world. No plans are gonna be changing. Actually, everything was already written in the book before you even knew. You're still heading towards bigger and better. I do feel like, again, this new relationship, going back to relationship, is going to lead to marriage eventually. I do feel like after 5 months of dating, you guys are gonna get engaged, and possibly under a year, you guys are gonna get married. And this is something that is for those who really, again, want to get married. If you don't want to get married, I feel like communication is key, and you guys can talk perfectly to your possible partner and say, hey, I want to wait a little bit longer. It's not the end of the world, okay? Communication is key. Not throwing tantrums like toddlers, right? It's communication. So I, at the end of the day, I do feel like a happy ending for you, a happy life, content, peaceful life, also financially stable. I do feel like there's no more insecurities here, indecisive energies here, no longer feeling like a failure, no longer feeling like you're alone. You're no longer with the devil capricorn energy in reverse, you know, allow like negative or excess that don't belong in your happy life. Like, you're no longer bothered by none of that. I do feel like there is a possible marriage for you. I do feel like there was a person that you really care for, but it was only friends with benefits. I do feel like that person's not gonna bother you anymore. I do feel like if that were a situation that they continue to bother you, you need to stop it. It's not gonna come from them because they want to continue being in your life. You need to be like, no, if you don't stop this person, it's gonna ruin your relationship. And of course, again, this part is for somebody specific. It's not for all of you. And finally, we have here, oh, the Ace of Swords, the Chariot, Ten of Pentacles, King of Cups, and the Seven of Swords at the bottom, the Four of Wands. I continue to have that for you, Aries. Look at that. This has been a rough year, and it's been a rough path, but every sacrifice becomes a success. Just so you know that thanks to your sacrifice and everything you went through, you're moving forward confidently. You're moving forward confidently to financial stability, to a happy family, to a foundation, to exactly what you wanted. A loving and emotional connected person who is established, who is faithful, who is caring. This is a relationship that is actually meant and written to last forever. This is not going to lead to divorce if it's handled properly. I do feel like this is for you to once again walk away from evil and unshady associations. Stay away from people that can actually show up in your life and act as a temptation. You don't want to ruin this, as everything that's coming from you for you now with this new individual seems to be very positive. But please don't be this person. Please don't play with people's feelings, and please don't allow evil and shady associations to get near you, because this association can cost so much in your happiness and in your future. But at the end of the day, if you do things correctly and you utilize your little brains here, you actually are heading towards a happy life. So don't mess this up, because I do feel like somebody who is, I feel like you guys could have a soul tie, but you guys are karmic lovers. This person right here is trying to get back into your life, but with the same attitude. And they are actually, you're very attracted to them, and they could act as a temptation. So I highly recommend you to block this individual whenever you get in their relationship, and keep them away from you as much as you can, because it can act as a bad temptation. And then you can actually screw up the amazing relationship you could have with this new partner that's coming to you. So with this said, let's move forward. Let's see. I'm going to give you the possible energies of the newer energy coming your way. Again, if you know, if you have a past person that could be a temptation, you don't need the energies, because you should know. If you don't have none, then you don't have to worry about that. So this is the newer energy. This could be the first, last, middle, or even a nickname. We have U as an umbrella, G as in George, O as in Oscar, Z as in Zane, Q as in Kesso, I as in Ian, T as in Tyler, Y as in Yes, E as in Edwin, C as in Cat, and 2 that I always do here. We got F as in Frank, W as in William, V as in Boy, and I also saw M as in Michelle for some reason. So those are the possible initials of the newer energy coming your way. So to finalize your reading, Aries, let me give you a message from your spiritual animal deck. From my spiritual animal deck, let's see. Let's see what the messages for you are. So we have at the bottom right here, we got the cougar. Assertive. In silence, you find power, claim your leadership role, and take action. You know where to go and what to do. You have the courage and confidence to succeed. The lynx right here, we got keeper of secrets. Take time out from the world and be the observer. Nothing can deceive you when you trust your knowing. You see others' secrets and keep them sacred. In silence and solitude, you will find your strength. Elephant, greatness. Love is your strength. Leadership is your path. Your wisdom inspires everyone you meet. You can overcome any problems. You will naturally and easily achieve success. And last one is dragonfly magic. I embrace my transformation. I courageously let go of the past. The magic of nature is in me. I am brilliant and I am blessed. So this is the energy reading, Aries. Thank you so very much for watching. Do not forget to like and subscribe. And if you want to win a free reading, make sure to subscribe to my channel, because every time my channel gains 1,000 subscribers, I host a free reading giveaway. Right now, I'm waiting for my channel to for sure stay on the 1,000 subscribers. And once I'm for sure know that I gained that. I'm gonna definitely make a video and I will tell you exactly what I'm getting, giving away, I should say, because every time I do this, I change the reading that I give. Also, I have a new giveaway for my subscribers. This happens every month regardless. I'm gonna be choosing one or two lucky subscribers to read their cards on a YouTube short as a thank you for everybody for supporting me. So if you want to be considered for both or either or, make sure to stay with me as every time I'm here. And once I gain 20K, I'm gonna be giving away other things as well. So you wanna always stay here so you can actually get things for free. With this said, I'll most likely show you my social medias. So if you follow me on Instagram, I always follow back. I also have a TikTok, do small readings over there. I have a small group on Facebook that I'm trying to grow. I have an upcoming project on my Patreon there. Once I launch it, I'm gonna be offering tarot reading classes as well as podcasts, uncensored readings, behind the scenes and vlogs. If you want to get a personal reading with me, I am available. You want to make sure to go to the description box below because there's the link from my website and it'll tell you the days and everything I do over there as well as my policy. If it's easier and more comfortable for you, you can always book directly on my Instagram. There is the book now button option. It's going to be on my bio and it'll take you to the same website. Just a friendly reminder that I do not take requests outside my website and I, once again, do not offer any free readings outside the giveaway. So please know that. With this said, guys, thank you so very much for the love and support. Make sure to know that I never message anybody on any of my platforms. So if that were to happen, just know that it's not me. And feel free to report and block, because in my account, in every single one of my accounts, I never message anybody, especially for readings, because I have my website. So just know that it were to happen like that, it's not my account, just block. So with this said, officially, thank you so much for the love and support. Have an amazing day. And of course, happy Valentine's Day in advance because it's around the corner. You guys are amazing and I love you.